Not dead. There we go. So we have to go in this place, but where in here we don't know. We do know, however, or I do anyway, that this is where I'd like to go. Unfortunately, I can't. Because there's really only one way to do this.
Be wary, friends. The
Shaitan, we have to go in here.
He's going to hurt himself.
Oh, drop. Drop.
What now, slaver?
Do not call me that.
But you have slaves.
I only wish to help them. As I myself was helped.
Help me.
You do no kindness imprisoning them like this.
Imprisoning
them? Sucks.
I keep them safe, preparing them for the journey that lies ahead.
What journey? It is a life of servitude.
You know nothing. It was folly to even bring you here. To think that you might see and understand.
I understand well enough. Show yourself.
Ah, so you want to see the man who called you here?
You did not call me here. I came on my own.
Oh boy.
Did you? Who unbarred the door? Cleared the path? Did you once raise your blade against a single man of mine, huh? No.
Yes.
All this I did for you.
Oh.
Step into the light then, and I will grant you one final favor.
You really have no choice here either that I'm aware of. You can't actually climb or jump or do anything. So you just kind of have to step into the light and, you know, hope for the best. And by hope for the best, I mean ninjas.
Now I stand before you.
Cool.
What is it you desire?
Murder.
Come down here. Let us settle this with honor.
Why must it always come to violence? It seems I cannot help you.
But you,
for you do not
ninjas.
Wish to help yourself. And I cannot allow my work to be threatened.
But you brought ninjas.
You leave me no choice.
Ninjas?
You must die.
Ugh. Why does it always have to come to violence? Oh, by the way, here's a shitload of ninjas. Hey, dude. Yeah. It's okay, guys. I don't want to fight you. I just have one small little issue to take care of. That guy. The rest I don't really care about. No, don't get me. Get someone else. Why are you running?
Away with you.
Oh, got ya.
You've nowhere to run now. Share your secrets with me.
Yeah, you're kinda dead.
My part is plain. The Brotherhood is not so weak that my death will stop its work.
What Brotherhood?
Yeah.
Al-Mu'alim is not the only one with designs upon the Holy Land.
Ooh.
And that's all you'll have from me.
Then we are finished. Beg forgiveness from your God.
He's long abandoned us. Long abandoned the men and women I took into my arms.
What do you mean?
Beggars, whores, addicts, lepers. Do they strike you as proper slaves? Unfit for even the most menial tasks? No. I took them not to sell, but to save. And yet you'd kill us all, for no other reason than it was asked of you.
No, you profit from the war, from lives lost and broken.
Yes, you would think that, ignorant as you are. Wall off your mind. They say it's what your kind do best. Do you see the irony in all this?
Well...
No, not yet, it seems. But you will.
Yet another person doing immense evil in the name of the other, of another, that honestly believes that he's doing good. And it's not the part about that that is interesting is that he actually believes it. And I'm not saying that he's a reasonable guy or anything like that, but it is of note that he does appear to believe genuinely that he's helping people by doing what he's been doing, which is patently untrue. Oh, Oh, come on, right as I got in there! I hope I can grab something here. Oh, man. Okay, good. I thought he was gonna sit on the edge again for a minute. Totally not here, guards. That is a lot of guys that were chasing me. Nope, never was here. Not an assassin. Just dress like one. It's fucking Halloween in the Holy Land. Oh, I missed. I missed it wrong.
Altair!
Where's my applause?
Wonderful to see you return to us. And how fared the mission?
I handled it. Well, I mean,
Talal is dead.
I had to arm myself. I mean,
no. In fact, the entire city knows. Have you forgotten the meaning of subtlety?
A skilled assassin ensures his work is noticed by the
one
men.
Hand washes
no,
the other. Oh,
a skilled assassin maintains control of his environment.
We can
grab the reins.
Details all you'd like, Malik. But the fact remains, I've accomplished the task set to me by Al-Muallim.
Go then. Return to the old man. Let us see with whom he sides.
You and I are on the same side, Malik.
Well, you're a little lopsided.
Fast forward.
I'm such a dick. I love it. Memory box? Block 3 complete. I believe it's complete. Which means we're not going to be going to see Al-Muallim. Not right away. We're going to have a little break. Have a little nap-ski.
God damn it! What's the problem now?
I'm getting weird temperature readings. I think the Animus is overheating.
That's
Christ,
not good.
It's always something! How long?
Too soon to tell.
I thought this was a tanning booth.
These delays are unacceptable, Miss Stillman. I want progress reports every hour.
It's gonna be a while, Desmond. Why don't you go lie down or something?
Because I want to look around at stuff. I sure do like things. But she did seem rather insistent that I go lay down, so maybe I should do that. Can I check his computer for Facebook? Gotta check my Facebook. Let everybody at the bar I work at know that I'm still alive. Notice, the only building you can see here is this one. But you can see out the windows. You can see perfectly fine. But every other building, except for this one, is shrouded in secrecy. Yes.
Why is he always yelling at you?
Oh.
It's his machine.
Yeah.
His theories. He's not the one who built it.
Who did? You?
No. Abstergo has a team of engineers. Not much they don't have. But I did oversee the assembly. Guess that's why he gets so angry with me.
He's a dick.
He's under a lot of pressure. We all are.
I can't believe you're defending the guy.
Warren saved my life. So if he wants to yell a little, let him.
I'm sorry, what? I have a... There's this... thing I need to.
What do you mean he saved your life?
Oh,
you're
they're
the
up there.
One
okay.
Who doesn't get to go home at night.
Wait, are you saying you're a prisoner?
Now she's begging me to look
you,
at it.
I was finishing up my PhD. The university had made it clear I had no future there. They didn't like the subject of my doctorate, called it pseudoscience. Said keeping me on would discredit and embarrass them. It was the same everywhere. Other universities, companies I interviewed with. Pretty soon I was out of money and out of time. I was this close to waiting tables.
Oh God.
Then I got a letter.
Not that.
Politic?
He said he'd been following my career since undergrad, that he believed in my work and wanted to meet to discuss my future. You have no idea how good it felt to hear that. So I met with him. What did I have to lose?
And he offered you a job.
Here.
Yes. Here at Abstergo, helping out on the Animus project. I'd have a chance to test my theories and prove the professor's wrong. How could I turn that down?
Think I'm missing
no?
The part where you became a prisoner.
Sometimes I wonder if they weren't behind it all. If they manipulated events so that I'd get desperate. They can do that. They can do anything. I didn't think when I agreed to come here. They even told me I'd be trapped. For 6 months, a year max. Once the product launched, there'd be no need for secrecy anymore. But until then, I'd be a guest of the company. At least, that's what they said.
And when the Animus was ready?
They came in while I was sleeping. Three guys. Guns.
Bummer.
They dragged me out of bed. God. The worst part is I knew them. One guy, Richard, we ate lunch together sometimes. And now he was gonna... They were cracking jokes. I tried to pull away. He hit me. And that's when he told me I was going to die.
Christ, what did you
do? Nothing. I kept telling myself it wasn't real. And then Warren was there, shouting at them to get away from me. And they listened.
Jesus.
He's not a happy man, Desmond. I wouldn't even say he's a good man, but he saved my life. They never came for me again. And he promised they never would.
You're still stuck here working for these nutjobs.
But I'm alive. Anyway, I really do need to get the Animus repaired. I'll see you tomorrow, Desmond.
Okay. Well, that's kind of a drag, but also sounds sort of like it might have been engineered to be that way. Let's go have a nap. Shall we?
What the hell?
Whoa.
Someone's been in here.
Whoa. Someone opened my towel drawer. Maybe they're just tired of me smelling like crap.
Looks like some kind of access code.
An access code. I wonder if it works on this. La 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 la. Lucy, I'm home. She's gone. But what's this? Can I use her computer again? No, but I can take the pen. Possibly Warren's pen? Possibly her pen. Either way, it's an access pen. Indeed it is possible. Is it this one? Brown. Aww. I thought it was brown. No, we haven't got the right stuff yet. But we can do this one. You're welcome, Lucy. Let's see here. Now we have a case file for Layla. Two of them. This is the first one. From Lucy. Dear Nancy, writing about the death of a former employee named Layla Marino. I don't know if you were working here at the time. Some kind of accident, not able to find any information. Indicated her file had been sealed as a suicide. Why is this information considered so sensitive? So she thinks it's a suicide. Not authorized to discuss it. I'm unable to respond. Okay, here we go. Yeah, this is the forwarding. I don't understand why her information is so difficult to access. Company ability to declare a coroner's report proprietary information. Alan Rickon. And Warren Vidic. She killed herself. Something about her relationship with a kid named Newman. Don't dip your pen in the company ink. Now drop it. You said wind up like Layla. Aha, okay. I get it. I see. Interesting. Nothing deleted. Nothing sent. Well, we stole Layla's pen and used it to hack into her computer. Did she give us access to this? I can't go have a lunch break. Dang it.
But I want pizza. Pizza.
Okie dokie. I don't know what any of this stuff's for. I'm pretty sure these are just server racks. You think I could, like, punch them? Maybe delay the Animus's fixing for a little while? However, there is one interesting bit. I believe I can actually go back into the Animus right now while nobody's around. Although it doesn't really do me any good. It just puts me back into the action. So I think I'm just going to sleep it off if I can. I don't know if I can. No, I can. Cool. Excuse me. I like to sleepy time. Sleepy time.
Oh my god! Stuff.
Rise and shine. We've got quite a day ahead of us.
You're peppy
today.
You're
in a good mood this morning.
Hey, I just said that.
Stillman has made some modifications to the Animus. You should be able to remain inside even longer now.
And help you with your treasure hunt.
This is serious business, Mr. Miles.
Serious business?
I don't think you fully appreciate the work that Abstergo does.
Maybe because I don't actually know what you people do.
Besides kill
people.
We
change the world. Every day, in 100 different ways. Did you know that nearly every single breakthrough of the past millennia, be it medical, mechanical, or philosophical, has come from Abstergo or its predecessors?
No.
That's a bold claim, Doc. Think you might be exaggerating a bit?
Not in the slightest. Oh, we certainly don't take the credit. That would arouse far too much suspicion. We choose our beneficiaries with great care.
Why?
Isn't it obvious? It means we're in control.
But how? What makes you guys so special, so smart, that you happen to invent all these things while us mere mortals stumble around like idiots?
Mm. To be fair, we don't invent them. We find them.
Important. Find them. Listen.
They're gifts, Mr. Miles. From those who came before.
Mm-hmm.
We'll have to continue this discussion later. Time's wasting.
Okie dokie. This technology, all the things that they've done and made to change the world for the better. The Animus and everything else. Gifts.
Hi.
From those who came before. Good morning.
I found your secret prize.
So, shall we go back to work then, everybody?
I liked reading about that lady who committed suicide, thank you.
Anyway. Let's go talk to Daddy. Pop Assassin. Who I believe is in memory block 4. Oops. Or I'll just drop my controller while hitting the button.
Throwing soldiers from rooftops and into structures is a useful way to create an escape route.
It is also hilarious. It makes a funny squishy sound.
You've done well.
The spinning
three
stone.
Of the nine lay dead, and for this you have my thanks.
Cool.
But do not think to rest upon your laurels.
My gloves.
Your work has just begun.
Who cares, gloves?
And yours to command, Master.
King Richard, emboldened by his victory at Arca, prepares to move south towards Jerusalem. Salah ad-Din is surely aware of this, and so he gathers his men before the broken citadel of Arsuf.
Would you have me kill them both then? End their war before it begins in earnest?
No.
No.
To do so would scatter their forces and subject the realm to the bloodlust of 10,000 aimless warriors. It will be many days before they meet, and while they march, they do not fight. You must concern yourself with a more immediate threat. The men who pretend to govern in their absence.
Give me names and I'll give you blood.
So I will. Abu Nukud, the wealthiest man in Damas, Majduddin, regent of Jerusalem, William of Montferrat, liege lord of Acre.
What are their crimes?
Greed, arrogance, the slaughter of innocents. Walk amongst the people of their cities. You'll learn the secrets of their sins. Do not doubt that these men are obstacles to the peace we seek.
Then they will die.
Another of your items is restored.
My favorite.
Take it.
Yay.
See that it is put to good use. Return to me as each man falls, that we might better understand their intentions.
Okie dokie. So, three men
and
placed...
Altair,
oh.
Take care. Your recent work has likely attracted the attention of the city guard.
Yeah.
They'll be more suspicious than they've been in the past.
Dang it. So, three men placed temporarily in charge of three major cities. Oh yeah. While the others, the true leaders, go out on a crusade. Catch Ledge and Grab Break, which is pointless, but Catch Ledge is great. Observe. That didn't work. But if you do a jump like that, you can grab onto the ledge, and if you side jump, you can. Why am I not ledge grabbing? Maybe I can't do it in here. I don't know.
Altair, it seems my students do not fully understand what it is to wield the blade. Perhaps you could show them what you know.
I'll stab them for you.